Welcome to Game Devs Play Games, where we play games about game design, and today we are here with another bonus series.
Yeah.
We're playing Hidden Folks, a charming, incredibly charming little game made by this fella, Adrian De Jong.
De Jong?
De Jong, and this person,
Sylvain Tegrog. Tegrog?
I wanted to make a point to show their names on screen because I can't pronounce their names very well.
Especially not yours, Sylvain.
So. This is an adorable little game. It's kind of like a more advanced, like, find-em-all kind of game.
Yeah.
So, like, okay, we're going to start this off. Explorer Garland is fascinated by the tongue of this reptile. So we're like, okay, so this dude is probably hanging out around, like, a reptile, so maybe this is him. Bam! Explorer Garland.
Yes.
So we go, okay, this big snake is a real bush crawler. And say, maybe he's behind some of these bushes. Oh, that's just a monkey. Hey, there it is. So the concept of the game is that you interact with the environment, move things around, and manipulate things to find these characters or hidden objects.
Right.
Which is, you know, it from a game design perspective, it's like, it's pretty simple, but like, it's fun.
It's very fun. And there's one aspect that makes it even more fun. The sound design.
Oh, it's so good.
It's
which is
delightful.
Why you're the one that gets to play this game with me, because they use all like vocalized human sounds for every single sound effect.
It's like it's all via the mouth, it would seem. It's all adorable, and like the like making a game that can actually suit just the human mouth as its sound effects, because like not every game can really do that because it just wouldn't make sense in plenty.
But
this one can do it so well because it's so goofy and it's so silly and it's just adorable.
And it's so like illustration feeling. So it's got this like storybook-ish feel. And then the human vocalized sounds kind of add that layer of charm to it that I think those two work very well together.
Yeah, especially if you have like a low budget for sound, then all you have to do is just make them with your voice and you can get infinite choices just by pitch shifting, and it's wonderful.
Oh yeah,
it's like all you have to do, really.
Okay, so first on the docket, this man is in distress. The uncomfortable seat is the least of his troubles. So I think this is him. Yeah, man in distress. So guy stuck on a log.
Hello.
We have ask if you ask classy Jesse, treetop naps are the best.
Aww. Jesse.
I like their way
there she is.
Of giving us hints where these characters are, because they don't straight up say where they are, but they're like, maybe look to the trees. The woman with the guitar plays music that will warm the hearts of men and reptiles.
Men and reptiles, huh?
So presumably we're going to find her around a campfire, surrounded by people and lizards. Woman with a guitar. Ono wishes he had paid more attention during his Tai Chi classes.
Oh no.
Saw this guy earlier.
Yeah, yeah.
We've got the monkey.
This is weird.
This little guy kind of drew my attention because he's bouncing around. Flying monkey.
Nice. So all this looks like it was drawn with Sharpie. And like I have a Sharpie opened right there, so I had to close it because I'm just feeling like this screen is...
It's too real.
Yeah.
It's breaking the fourth
making
wall.
Making me smell all this Sharpie.
Okay, Fluffy Panda does what Fluffy Pandas do, eating. So pandas eat bamboo. So if I seem a little good at this, it's because I was sticking around with this earlier. So I've already played through this level.
Gotcha.
And I kind of remember where most of these guys are.
That's so fun. Yeah,
Panda.
So we can, so we unlock the next area. We could stay here or we could find the rest of these guys.
Yeah.
I say, let's find the rest of them because it won't take that long.
Yeah, there's only five. Six. Okay.
The others watch jealously while King Kiki sits on his throne of bananas. So,
where's you and your bananas?
Bunch
of monkeys,
bananas.
Yo,
throne
of bananas.
King Kiki.
King, wait, he was on bananas?
Yeah, he was on the throne of bananas.
Oh,
see all the bananas?
No, there's the bananas. I didn't see him at first.
Long, elegant birds lay long, elegant eggs.
Long, elegant eggs.
I don't remember this
elegant
one.
Elegant birds.
Oh, maybe.
Oh, flamingos.
Hey.
Shmegs.
This chicken was a single bite-sized dinner.
Single bite-sized dinner. Campfire.
So, I think it's pretty safe to say this will be a pretty casual playthrough compared. Hey, look, I found a little lizard guy.
Nice. Nothing too rough in this gameplay.
His hint was this reptile laughs at the amateur trying to catch a butterfly.
Certainly ain't no rise and shine.
I know, right?
It's not nearly as stressful.
This might actually come out before Rise and Shine, depending.
Well, they'll know what I mean either way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, so this is a snake. So we go bloop, bloop, bloop.
Aw.
Found you, buddy.
That was adorable. Yeah. Bird enthusiast, I saw her up there.
Bird enthusiast pretty much in heaven right now. Up here? Not her.
Oh, where did I see her?
Yeah, I like how a lot of these characters tend to look the same, right? Because they all follow the same art style.
Right.
But no matter what, you'll only find one version of these characters throughout an entire scene. So they made it. I think that's one of the most important design choices that they made, was that the ones you look for are always unique.
Gotcha.
Because otherwise you kind of feel like, well, I totally found them. It's not fair.
Yeah,
game.
It looks just like him.
And that's also one of the best things about this being a game instead of like a book, like Where's Waldo?
Yeah.
Is that you know absolutely whether you're right or wrong because the game tells you. So birds. You gotta find birds.
Birds.
Where are there a lot of birds?
Birds. I mean, the birds are birds.
Probably
birds.
Not by the flamingos, because why would we have two people next to each other? We have a net. Maybe not.
I thought maybe like she's. Oh, she's practically in heaven right now.
Oh, oh, oh.
Like, oh, birds.
And then last but not least. Only a secret passage will lead you to the shaman. Because waterfall.
Wow, you found him right away.
Waterfalls always have secrets, man.
Yeah, that's true.
There's no such thing as a game that doesn't have
a secret behind a waterfall. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And if you're making a game that has a waterfall, you best put one secret behind there. At least one. At least one.
There's nothing to find here. Help that walking folk get across. So I think this is probably my favorite thing about this game, right? We have to, it's this little person that's walking across, we have to click things to get them out of her way.
Huh.
I don't know if you can lose this. I think she just, like, kind of sits there. Be like, can I pull it down? No.
It's there.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Lower the little bridge.
It just, like, launches up
be if you're
like, holding it. Throws them into the air.
Get out of here, snake.
Oh, it's a
get
snake.
Out of here, birds.
Yeah.
Gotta clear this path. Gotta clear out this bamboo. So I like that they kind of
like a slurping sound for the bamboo disappearing. Oh, God.
But you see what I mean? How, like, they're reusing the same exact mechanics that they used to, like, shift the environment around and, like, have the player find things. And they're just, like, making this fun little extra challenge.
Yeah.
It's like, it's really nothing different from a programming standpoint, other than, like, programming this person to, like, walk.
Yeah.
From point A to point B.
It's very simple.
Super cute.
Super adorable. Oh, no, where is it going? Where's she going?
She's gotta go done? She's gotta go down here.
Oh, she did it. Knock the ladder over.
We did it.
We did it.
All right. To the backyard campground.
Bring a tent.
So they kind of have this flow to their level structure where they'll, like, they'll start us off with kind of a tutorial zone. So this is a new tutorial zone.
Yeah.
We're going to say, okay, the guitar is having a really good conversation with the swing. So we find this. But it also teaches us some new mechanics, like, hey, there's these X's on the ground. That means there are things buried under there. So now we just found a hairbrush.
Ugh. I'll clean that off first.
Found a bone. So they use these little mini segments to teach us how things are going to change for the next segment. And then they throw us into the next area, which is like the big zone that we were in before. They open it up and kind of open the gambit.
Mm-hmm.
So now to the big campground.
So many people. Oh my goodness.
Right? So, like, I think this is where the game really shines, right? Because there's so much happening on screen. But it's fun, right? Like, from an illustration standpoint, there's so many little things to see and discover, and everyone's kind of, like, doing their own thing. Like, look at this, for these two people at the picnic bench who are like, I don't know, what's happening over here? Oh, there's the beehives and people like...
I want to be a part of this community.
Right? Like, there's so many little, like, things going on that even though we're specifically looking for, like, Beekeeper Barry, we're like, we gotta find Beekeeper Barry, but then you're also curious about all the other things going on. So I think the design is strong, right? And this is present in things like I Spy or Where's Waldo, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where, like, the rest of the environment has to be engaging. Otherwise, searching for the thing you're looking for isn't fun.
Yeah.
So it's an interesting way to look at exploration in from a visual standpoint in games.
Mm-hmm. There's an X marks the spot below you. Also, there's Beekeeper Barry right there.
Nothing.
It's Beekeeper Barry right above you.
Oh. What's up, buddy?
There he is.
All right. May releases every butterfly she catches. That's why there's so many of them here. So our hint is...
Lots of butterflies down over right here. This area. Lots of butterflies. Oh, there's just butterflies everywhere.
Yes.
Oh, there's more over here.
Bam. Did it.
Nice. What's the next guy?
Lumberjack Flex stands in front of his grand final challenge. All right.
So big tree.
Big tree.
Yeah.
And we've got the sun is shining too brightly today, even for Classy Jesse. Which Classy Jesse was in the last environment.
Just a big old community.
Dude, right? Do. Little pickaxe.
Ooh.
Don't know if these do anything. I mean, it's kind of fun that we can, like, dig up a little X on the ground and be like, oh, look at pickaxe.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't do anything. But
it's fun.
It's still fun to be like, what's in this hole?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe. Yeah.
Classy Jesse.
Just when Pika thought he had escaped the crazies, it turns out he put his tent next to the only Wi-Fi point in the campground. So we have Wi-Fi and a little Pokeball.
Where is he?
Yeah.
Pika.
Monster Mo watches society from a distance. What would it be like to be one of them? I think... Yeah, I remember this guy. Because he's my favorite in this spot.
Monster Mo. Stay here. Someone here thinks to find.
Banana?
Oh, God.
Banana was parked into a fruit basket.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, so this is at the point, parked. Especially when you get later on in these. So I think they do a really good job at kind of like scaling the difficulties. So easiest tends to be on the left. And as you move through it, it tends to get more difficult, which is very smart. Oh, look at that.
Huh. Yeah, I mean, it was parked, so that was the right area.
Right, but I think what it does is it sets up each level to have a natural difficulty curve without really, like, doing much to force that. Little bathrooms. A huge line outside.
Oh, there's no one inside of them.
Okay, we have to find a pig, because Truffle's about to be discovered by a hog. Oh, pigs.
Truffle.
Yeah.
Ah.
Together with her bunny friends, Black Biddy hides in a hole chewing on some snatched wheat. I think I remember... Huh?
Oh, there it is. Black Biddy.
Ivan hitched a ride without permission and doesn't have an escape plan.
He's got squiggles on his chest. Or a shirt.
I think Ivan was the one that I struggled with the most when I was playing on my own. But he is hidden in... There you are.
Ah. Damn it, Ivan.
Tortoise Raffaello to rise in the sun. So...
Man, that must have sucked for Ivan to be stuck inside that thing in the sun.
Right?
Ugh.
Oh, I found a spider.
Oh, a speeder.
So this is actually something else worth talking about, too, is... The game kind of sets it up so that you can discover things in any order.
Oh, yeah.
Which I think is super important, especially, like, there are some things that seem...
He's right down, right there.
Hey!
Yeah.
So there's a lot of things that are like, this looks like a unique thing. That's why I clicked on the spider. I was like, I wonder if this is something. And then it was.
And a little spider friend.
So it kind of becomes this very intuitive way of trying to discover things because it sets up expectations and then fulfills them.
Right.
How much time do we have? 6 minutes?
Yes. 6 minutes.
Okay, so this is the area that I haven't really done much. Farmer Wyatt takes his job as wheat supervisor very seriously. Is this him? Oh, that's him. Pitchfork versus hay,
1-0. Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Looks like a devil's, like, pike.
I mean, it's what pitchforks are.
Right you are.
If you water your crops well and give them a little bit of extra attention, you may see this rare flower. Boop, 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 boop. Yeah.
Oh, where was that?
So, the...
Oh.
Actually, this warrants a discussion that we haven't had yet. But the way that this game works is once you interact with something, it stays. So, like... You can only add to it or like remove something, and it doesn't cycle, which is, I think, probably the most important thing about this game. Because imagine, like, you know, you could, like, keep these plants cycling up and down.
Mm-hmm.
What it tells the player is that once it's done with everything it can do,
it
stops.
Yeah.
So the player not only remembers, hey, I've already interacted with these things, but the other thing is, like, you know not to look back in that area.
Mm-hmm.
It's a really good way of keeping track of everything that you've already interacted with. I mean, there are some cases where that, you know, that doesn't hold, right? Like, we can move this back and forth. But I think for the anything like the plants in, like, big things, I think it makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm.
Especially, like, there's a very obvious loop for this, so it doesn't really defy logic.
Mm-hmm.
Just imagine this, like, would shrink up and down, or, like, if it got all the way up, then it would, like, start back at, you know...
Yeah, because you caused it to grow up, and then the in the other areas, you've chopped down branches and leaves and things, and they stayed down.
Mm-hmm.
If you click them again, they're not going to just grow back again.
All right. An ancient Native American spirit suddenly possessed Forester Awan.
Ooh.
Okay. So I've not touched this level at all.
Oh, boy.
So now we're actually really playing the game.
Oh, no.
So what do you think about this game?
It's adorable.
Oh, nothing. It's... Hey, Harry. What was Harry's thing? According to Harry, invisible cattle is also cattle.
Oh, Harry. I'm right there with you,
what
Harry.
A guy. I think the sound effects are...
They're so good.
They add so much more to the exploration, because it's like, every time I click something, I want to be like, how did they do this one? And like, at a certain point, it got me, like, saying things along with the game to be like...
That would have been hilarious to watch you play.
This totally seemed like a guy.
Yeah.
Wait. If there's a chicken man... Maybe that means...
There's a scarecrow nearby, right? Up there?
Scarecrow?
Right? There's got to be a scarecrow up there, because we're looking for a scarecrow, too, eventually.
We are?
Yeah, right there.
Oh. This hi-hat scarecrow is really arrogant. He only likes when...
Likes
wheat, not crops. Wants his area to be watered, and will only show himself when the wheat has fully grown.
Oh,
that's cool.
That's
okay,
a way
so
to...
this is a lot more... complex. Oh, wow, that person just, like, popped out of the ground. So that's, like, a way more complicated way of hiding someone, which I think is honestly what I was hoping to see out of this
game.
Like, it's a lot more incentive to just, like, keep poking things.
I was just gonna say, like, what else are they gonna do to make it even more, engaging? And here it is. Perfect.
So, like, as far as casual games go, I think this is, like, this really satisfies everything I would ever want out of a game like this.
Be careful, though. You didn't fully grow some of your wheat, I think. Go right there. Yeah, there you go. There you go. It was that spot.
Grow all of your wheat.
One day is when we're going to find a scarecrow.
But I think I really like, though, how, like, this game doesn't try to be more than what it wanted to be.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's not... It doesn't implement, like, a loose scenario, right? Or, you know, there's no, like... You have to do things really fast, or it doesn't even, like, award you a score based on how quickly you found everything, right?
Yeah,
it wanted
don't have
to
a time
be,
limit either.
Yeah, it wanted to be charming, it wanted to be very, like, casual and relaxing.
Yeah.
And I really respect the game for sticking to its guns with that.
Mm-hmm.
So much wheat. Like, girl, do it.
It's a nice, fun little educational game, in a way.
You think so? I guess it has the potential of acting like an educational game.
Problem-solving skills, specifically, I mean.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's actually pretty fair.
Yeah.
Because then there's kind of a logical connection to things.
Yeah. A little bit, at least.
Oh.
Hey! I wonder if we
it
only had to do that.
It's totally possible. That's all right. That's okay. It was fun growing all that wheat.
That was fun.
Still need to find... Wait.
Oh, it's nothing? No.
Gotta do something.
There's more. More apples down.
What's this? Yeah. Aw. Hmm. I love that people are just, like, hanging out in the trees.
Hey, man.
If you click them, they're just like, whoop!
Yay!
Did you get all your apples?
Slapple pickin'.
Slapple pickin's!
Yax! Yax!
You mean this?
Yeah.
Beehive!
Oh, I'll behave. There's nothing in it, though. Ugh.
Oh.
What?
Oh! Oh, totem pole. Haha. That was more obvious than I
yeah.
realized.
Oh, well.
It's time to get some fruity physics with Newton's head. That's what I thought I was doing with these apples!
Aww.
All right, we just gotta find Newton and hit him on the head. Wait. No. One of these apple trees holds the key to gravity.
Well, this is the apple orchard over here.
Yeah, did I miss one? Maybe he's just, like, hanging out over here. It's not him, is it? No. You him? He's got a tie.
He's got a little tie.
It's a little face.
It's unique. He's sitting down, too.
So he's probably under a tree, which only makes sense. Oh, there you are.
Oh, hey.
What's up, buddy? Needle might not be in a haystack, but she sure knows how to roll.
Oh, boy. Right there. Oh, wait, no, never mind. Sorry. Wrong lady. Right there, next
Bam.
To the wheat. Oh. Oh, she's got a different skirt and hat. Oh, my bad. My bad.
This rotting fish is repelling potential customers.
Potential customers are here, over in this market.
But they're not being repelled. Maybe... It's gotta be, like, a spot where... There's just, like, no people. Or maybe... Hey, hey. I like their way of hiding things, too.
Was it underneath the haystack?
Yeah.
Ah.
So they have the, kind of two main ways of hiding something, right? Just,
yeah.
like, hiding something in plain sight because it looks similar to other things.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, hiding it under a condition.
Mm-hmm.
Which seems pretty appropriate for an interactable form of media.
Indeed. We're 2 minutes over.
That's okay.
Sorry.
I figure,
this
do you think we should do one episode on this, or do you think we should do multiple?
You can do one.
Yeah.
One is cute, right?
That's kind of what I'm thinking. So
yeah,
let's,
I think
let's
one
go
is
a little
good.
Long on this. I want to kind of like see what some of the other environments are like, too. Big Bull Barney is not
He's right there.
Because...
I see him. He's right there. Nope. Nope.
Big Bull Barney. Wait.
Yeah.
Maybe this is because he's fake and has no feelings, but how do we know he's fake?
I don't know.
That's okay.
Hmm.
Chicken Chuck hasn't gotten too far, but at least he's free. Freedom!
Wait. I don't think Fake Bull Barney moves his head at all.
Oh, you're right. Ah, sneaky.
Sneaky. Right up there. Right there. Nope. The one next to it. Oh, no? Not that one?
Whoa.
Wait, peacock. My bad. Didn't even notice you were a peacock. Sorry, miss. Or sir, actually. That's right.
Well, I assume this chicken is outside of the pen, right? Because he's like, freedom!
Oh, okay. See, you don't let me read it before you click away from it.
I read it out loud. Gotcha,
chicken Chuck. I wasn't listening, so, you know.
All right, onto the desert.
The desert.
And then it's all the things that we found. They're all just like hanging out together. Like, what's up, everyone?
That's fun.
We're all the important people.
Oh. Oh, boy.
So now they hide things.
Oh, no.
Yeah, now it's not hidden in like tight spaces. Now it's like.
What's that?
Everything is far apart from each other. It's just sheer space.
Oh, God.
Look at all this space.
Oh, no.
You could get lost here.
Oh, goodness. Well, it is the desert.
Right?
Arizona.
Yeah. Okay, what do you have to say? Fabian wants to get back to the festival, but the signs aren't helping him. Okay, so we need to look for signs. Also, buried treasure.
Why is there fish buried in the desert? It's weird. It's a desert. It's not an ocean.
Hey, some deserts used to be oceans.
It's because millions of years ago, they used to be oceans.
It's true.
I was about to say that. You stole my thunder.
Yeah.
Jerk.
What up? What are these little guys?
Little squid. It looks like a squid.
Looks kind of like a little squid. Hey, Mr. Worm.
Mr. Worm.
We also have a cactus with a hat. Okay, signs, right. Don't get distracted, Chris. We have to find a sign. Also, buried treasure.
You're getting distracted. Okay.
This guy has like a little dice on his shirt.
Yeah. That man is not wearing a shirt.
Burning folks.
Well, while you're here, roll up these tents.
That's a lot of tents.
Yeah, it's a lot of tents. A lot of stuff could be inside these tents. You don't know.
It's true.
A lot of tents. A lot of things inside these tents. What's that?
Nothing.
Oh, that could be a thing.
Hey, I remember that hairbrush.
Oh, the hairbrush we dug up. Can you open these tents? These teepees?
So,
can you open them further? Yeah, there you go.
Talking about the art style of the game too, I think it was a very important choice that they chose to not use color.
Yeah, it may have been a little bit too painful for the eyes.
Instead of like it being this kind of like really like, I don't know, kind of mellow experience, mm-hmm. with color it just could be too chaotic.
Yeah.
And like there are ways to use the color well, right? And
yeah.
like old books like Where's Waldo used color to like just make it that much more difficult to spot things, but instead they used color and pattern to make Waldo identifiable, right? Mm-hmm. And so that's where that was strong. This, I think, because we're not looking for one specific object,
yeah,
I think it makes a lot more sense for us to be looking for, you know, unique shapes among a field of repeating objects.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we have a sign. Maybe. Oh.
And also.
Oh, he moves.
Oh, this guy.
Oh, he's like moving
between these two.
Yes.
That's adorable.
Chief
Toto was standing up a minute ago.
Oh, man. That hint is not very helpful.
Well, we saw teepees a little bit ago. Walter White's van.
Also, like, pelted with arrows.
Oh, no.
Although maybe if there are arrows, that means that Chief Toto is over here.
And also, you kind of have to. Most people might get close to their screen while playing this. So would it be better to choose just like a grayscale color palette? So it doesn't hurt people's eyes if they're looking too closely? Or does that matter?
Oh, I mean, absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. Where is he? Okay, he was standing up a minute ago. Look at the teepees that fell over.
Oh! You're so smart.
Yeah, nice.
Oh, I was going to ask you something.
Oh, wonderful.
With the signal in place, Eric hopes for help from up above. Signal.
Oh, God. Oh, boy.
I don't know what that one
Go back to the burning folks. because they're, because it's like Burning Man, and they're live videoing it. They're videotaping it live, live stream, signal, live stream Burning Man, Burning Folk.
What?
Huh? You're nothing. You're not anything. Really? All right, fine. You're worthless.
Okay, so this person is like sitting down. So many buried treasures.
Get them all.
Do you think that there should be like little achievements for? Oh, that was a bug. Oh, that was a bug. Do you think that there should be little achievements for like unearthing all buried treasures?
I bet you there is, and there probably should be, because I know we didn't find them all.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of like, how could you reward the player in other little ways for exploring things that aren't part of the main objective of the game? And I don't think the game necessarily needs it, right? But I don't think it would hurt either.
Oh, it wouldn't hurt, no.
Because the main game flow of this is we find enough people.
Where did that car go?
Oh. Aliens.
Aliens. Whoopsie doodles. Oh boy.
But the main game flow, right, is that you find enough people until you can unlock the next area. So really the reward is giving the player new levels.
Yeah.
Which is a pretty standard like reward in a game, especially for a game like this.
Right.
So what other kinds of rewards do you think you could give players that would feel substantial in a game like this? I mean, there's plenty of aesthetic things you could do, right? Like maybe you could like, I don't know, change the color scheme, or maybe like the cursor, or I don't know.
I guess I was gonna say something like maybe changing color scheme, like have color options, just for like a hard mode, I guess.
Yeah, right. I guess
it doesn't need it though.
Furry Max.
What was his story?
Furry Max. One horn wasn't enough for scavenger Furry Max. Is it like Mad Max inspired?
It's gotta be. Furry Max. Theory Max, Mad Max, Fury Road.
Ah, I see. Okay, so we have a satellite dish here.
Yeah.
I feel like this person can't be too far,
open
right?
Open up some things.
Oh?
No.
No.
Different shirt, different hat.
Yeah, you're right. That's so cute.
I'm gonna go back to the left.
Ooh.
Okay, stay right here. Now, click on the water tower. Oh, really?
Nothing. Yeah, maybe he's not over here.
There's the signal tower, but
with the signal in place, Eric hopes for help from above. Maybe we have to find a UFO. I mean, that makes sense, right?
It's a desert. Yeah.
Maybe he found the help already. Oh, I feel like, yeah, I was like, that's totally something. Should we go to the next place?
No, we gotta find, okay, if anything, we have to find the cactus with the freaking sombrero.
Yes, okay, I agree.
But first we gotta find Eric, because I kind of like that idea that he might be a looking for a UFO. Oh boy.
Oh, I remember what I was gonna say. Do you think that it would be a disservice to this game to have, like, say, like, maybe this is Eric right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it would be a disservice if we had to, like, find a way to knock him over so he was sitting down before we could actually say we found him?
Yeah, that'd be a disservice, because really, like, some eagle, all right.
That was... my favorite sound effect so far.
Yeah, I don't think it would be a good idea for that, because the whole point is to find them in this, it's a shape finding game. It's like you have to find them in that shape.
Yeah, I totally agree, right? Because imagine if you had to manipulate the characters in this in order to get the goal of finding them.
Mm-hmm. Well, instead you're manipulating the environment for certain ones.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a trade there.
And I think the core difference is that it would make this into a puzzle game rather than as a find things game.
Mm-hmm.
This is like a party. Oh, I can turn on and off the music.
That's awesome.
Maybe it's nothing. Maybe it's Maybelline. Oh. Well, oh, maybe if I have everyone dance, something happens. I need more boomboxes. Also, you hear the little, like, music?
That's awesome.
Man, this dude's not easy to find.
No, he's not. Where?
Burning folks. I mean, we found the Burning Man.
Yeah.
Where did he go? There he is. Yeah.
Nice.
Well, we'll skip him. We'll come back to him. Who else do we have? Si, senor, this Mexican cactus resides somewhere in the outskirts of the desert.
Outskirts, all right.
Bam. Let's look on the outskirts. I like that they increase the challenge of the game too by just changing environment. They don't add any new mechanics. What they do is they choose environments that naturally comes with different complexities.
There he is.
Boom. So like, the desert is a good example, right? And we kind of already talked about this, but the idea being like everything's very far apart and we just have a larger space to work with.
Mm-hmm.
I imagine it in the later levels when we get to like the urban zone, there's just so much in such a tight packed space that it makes sense that that would be probably the most difficult.
Mm-hmm.
It was.
This just feels difficult because it's so wide, but still, it's just time consuming more than difficult.
Yeah, yeah. And maybe that's like the main thing about this game, right, is that it's not it's not that it's challenging, it's that the design is basically set up to expect the player to be willing to spend X amount of time on it.
Mm-hmm.
So and that's honestly why I would say it's more of a casual game, right, because it's designed so that anyone should be able to play it,
right,
and still ideally have fun with it.
Mm-hmm.
Ding.
What? Hmm.
Oh, man, I feel like this has got to be something.
Mm-hmm.
Little scorpion buddy. I love that he just kind of goes... What are we looking for? Glasses, that's right. Yeah, the little objects I feel like are the most difficult. So we have to find 3 vultures. And then probably a dead body?
Hmm. Likely a dead body. Ooh, oasis.
Probably.
Is there anything here?
Dead fish.
Hmm.
You know, the other important thing about things like this, right? You might be like, oh, well, this is a unique thing. Mm-hmm. Why isn't there anything we can discover here?
Mm-hmm.
I think this is important because what it does is it allows the player to kind of build this internal sense of the map.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, you're like, oh, well, yeah. I remember there were, you know, these types of, like, this rock standing next to the oasis.
Yeah.
So if you get a hint later on as you're going down the line, that's your way of kind of being like...
Maybe if I didn't find that scorpion, maybe it's over by the oasis. Oh, it's in the bottom right corner of the screen. Mm-hmm. That's right.
So it helps...
Or towards the right middle, kind
of. Yeah, it helps give the player things to keep track of where they've been.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think is really smart, right? Like... If it was just, like, constantly repeating patterns, I could see this game getting really redundant really quick.
Right. And over by the dunes, maybe. Is Eric in the dunes? I honestly think Eric's a lost fucking cause.
He probably is.
Oh, his parents say
picnic.
Well.
Hey, I found a bottle of water. That's probably very important to have.
Yeah, it's also probably evaporated now.
Yeah, well, you never know.
Yeah.
Huh?
Nothing. No. It's nothing.
It's nothing. Little scorpion buddy. Secret boombox.
The sound effects from that. Oh my gosh.
So if you were to design an area for this game, what would you do?
Hmm.
Seems like they enjoyed doing very like normal things. Like, they're not doing, like, fantasy world or, you know, like, it seems very, like, modern day. And I think that's kind of what is also so charming about it, right? It's like, yeah. Oh, these are just normal people in a camping ground doing, like, cute things because they're cute people.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what I would design, because I would say city, honestly. I would do city one.
Yeah, like urban area?
Yeah, but I mean, they have that, so.
It seems like probably... Oh,
oh boy.
It seems like a very natural place for a game like this.
Yeah. I was going to say Desert Island, too. But...
Desert Island could be fun. Well, like, this is a desert, but it's not a desert island.
Yeah.
This could be two very different things.
Mm-hmm.
I'm never going to find these glasses either. We're going to die out here. I think, if anything, I would want to design, like, some, like, weird sci-fi thing. Like, 60s or 70s, like, sci-fi land.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I know that would be kind of, like, super different from the aesthetic of the game.
Yeah.
But, like, I don't know. I feel like that would fit into the natural charm of this game pretty well, too.
Mm-hmm. It might become a little messy if it was sci-fi, though.
It depends. A lot of the old art for, like, 60s and 70s sci-fi was, like, it was like pulp sci-fi, right? So they tended to use pretty simple, rounded shapes.
Yeah, that's fair. I guess it just depends on what kind of sci-fi you do.
That's true. Oh. Nothing.
I was hoping it would turn on. More music. More music.
All right. Well, we could call this here. We don't have to find everything.
Yeah, no, we can. Yeah, that's fine.
But this game is super charming.
So charming.
And I was very... I don't regret... picking this up, not even for a second,
because
I'm going to keep having fun with this. Maybe I'll stream it too if people really want to see more. Or, I guess, let us know if you want us to play the rest. We kind of figured this would be kind of a weird one to play on the show, because, I mean, like, all of the design is in the visuals, really.
Yeah.
So it's pretty easy to run out of things to talk about, I guess.
A little bit, but still, I mean, we could have gotten to the urban area and maybe talked a little bit more too, but...
It's true. Let's go...
If people want to see it, we can do a thing. Oh, we can go to it if you want.
I mean... Oh, this is like a loading screen. Ah, it's super cute.
Yeah, everything that you find, right?
Yeah, so they've got city... Oh, factory is probably their hardest mode right now. And it looks like they're still making more areas, so who knows, they might make more still.
Yeah.
But we got... We were almost to the city, actually. We were right at the end of the drylands.
Oh. Goodness.
Ah, so charming, though. No, I'm happy that we played this.
We are at the city, though, because that first one is open.
That's true. Well... We'll save that for if you guys want us to come back.
Save it.
Well, thank you for watching, everyone.
Thank you.
Question of the day: what do you think about Hidden Folks and kind of how they set up the game mechanics and in the challenge? Do you think that it's missing anything? Do you think it has everything it needs, or do you think it has more than it needs?
What do you think? Let us know.
Well, until then, we'll see you in the comment section. Thank you for watching, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for watching. Have a good one.